especially my students for strategic management. You listen why I did not accept your answer to my question. My question was, what is the relevance of strategic management? It means to say, why is strategic management important? Relevant, important. Maraming sumagot, ang bagsak ng answer, to become competitive, to become successful. Most of you were my students before. Diba sabi ko, huwag kayong sasagot ng to become successful unless ma-explain nyo yung process, bakit, or specifically, you were able to explain. Okay. Ang sagot, dun bumabagsak. Kasi, kung sasabihin nyo to become competitive or to become successful, lahat ng subject, lahat ng courses, ang objective is to become successful. Okay. So, ang tinatanong ko, why strategic management is important? Sinabi ko na, there are three factors. So, niliwanag ko na. Kung na-view nyo yung lecture, there are three factors that made strategic management relevant. We need to strategize. Always remember that strategic management is long-term objective. Before you establish your business, you have already your vision and mission statements. Therefore, where do you want to go and what you should be doing and what is the reasons for your existence? Okay, so yung mga sumagot ng pricing strategy, hindi porke may strategy, strategy na siya. It's a short-term strategy. Ang tinatanong natin sa strategic management, nandun na nga sa video eh. Yung iba nakasagot, yung iba, basta may nakalagay na marketing, basta may nakalagay na strategy, strategy. No, strategy can be short-term and can be long-term. So, strategic management is focused on long-term strategy of a business. That's why first you have to formulate or create your vision statement. Okay, what is the importance of strategic management? Nilinaw ko na. There are three factors that made strategic management relevant. Okay. Number one. Okay. Number one reason why strategic management is important. Number one, there are three factors. Okay. There are three factors that made strategic management relevant. Number one factor is globalization. Number two is technology. The emergence of technology or ICT, information and communication technology. One, two, third is tariff free agreement. Or sometimes they call it free trade agreement, FTA, or we have the AFTA, Asian Free Trade Agreement, and also we have the NAFTA. Okay. Mahalaga ang strategic management because of globalization. Because of globalization, we are competing with global markets, global suppliers, and global customers. Lumaki yung expansion natin because of globalization, pero lumaki din ang competition because of globalization. Example, Jollibee is a local fast food chain in the Philippines. Kung walang globalization, Jollibee exists within the country, magkaroon man ng competition, Filipino rin, local competition lang. So ang kikita, tayo-tayong mga Pilipino. But because of globalization, pumasok ang McDonald's. Because of globalization, pumasok ang King Burger, pumasok na yung Dunkin' Donuts, US yan. Mga coffee shop, Starbucks, Auntie Anne's, pumasok na. Mga US company yan. So we're competing globally. We're not competing locally. We're competing now globally. So because of globalization, there is a great competition. That's why we need strategic management. And then the emergence of technology. Ano ang impact ng technology sa industry? lalo na sa Pilipinas. Noong nag-emerge ang technology, particularly yung sinasabing ICT or Information and Communication Technology, we can now sell our products online, okay? So there is a great possibility, even in US, they have specific statistics, trillion of dollars will be gained by online sellers. Malaki ah, trillion dollars, I don't remember, 4.9 trillion, okay, ang papasok sa online seller. So matatalo yung mga bricks and mortars store like SM and other department store. Because of technology, nagkaroon ng online selling as well, website. You can sell more on website. Companies are earning more selling online. Malaki ang kinikita ngayon ng mga marketers, ng mga seller through online. So, nagkaroon ng mga website. Kaya ang marketing system has changed the market space. Okay? We can optimize the use of technology. Otherwise, we will be lost in the marketplace. Nung nag-umpisa ang technology, kasama ang emergence ng social media, emergence as well as convergence of technology and social media. Hindi ba may mga nawalang business? Ano yung mga business na nalugi nung nagkaroon na ng mga Facebook, Gmail, Messenger, Zoom? Hindi ba ang postal services hindi na kumikita? Not only in the Philippines, but even the postal services in US, in Canada. Lahat ng postal services bumagsak because of technology. Bakit ka magbabayad ng stamps? Ang mahal-mahal ng stamps at the same time, ang bagal-bagal pa. So they call it snail mail. Okay. So technology has improved our lifestyle and our communication system. As well, educational system. Marketing system, everything has changed because of technology. And then ano ang impact ng free trade agreement? Ang impact ng free trade agreement, lumaki ang competition because of globalization. At the same time, nagtanggal tayo ng tariff. Dati we have the so-called tariff barrier. Ibig sabihin, ayaw magbenta ng mga kumpanya ng imported kasi pag imported ang product mo, malaki yung tax or tariff na sinisingil ng gobyerno. Kumbaga yung kotse mo na luxury car, ang halaga 2 million pesos, nagiging 3 to 4 million, doble, halos minsan doble as per their assessment. Doble yung tax. So, yung importer, nadi-discourage silang mag-import, okay? Kasi nga, malaki yung tax. Ang hirap ibenta yung item. Okay. E ngayon, inalis na natin yung tariff. We remove the tariff. When we remove the tariff, yun yung sinasabi nating free trade agreement. We remove the tariff barrier. Noon, nadi-discourage sa mga imported goods na pumasok sa Pilipinas kasi malaki yung tax na sinisingil ng gobyerno. E ngayon, inalis mo yung tax, tapos nagkaroon ng technology, yung produkto ng kalaban mo sa abroad, nakikilala na sa global community because of technology. That technology as well as globalization have diminished the border. Okay? So, wala nang barrier, wala nang division. So, we are now operating as one community because of globalization and technology. So, itong tatlo na to, ang these are the three factors that made strategic management relevant. Kung nasa classroom type tayo, kung isa lang ang hinihingi ko eh, kung may nakasagot ng kahit isa at na-explain ng maayos, ini-exempt ko na hanggang final. Okay, some of you were exempted before sa traditional classroom, di ba? Sabi ko mag-online na lang kayo, exempted na kayo. Because you were able to answer greatly, correctly, specifically. Pero yung to become competitive, to become successful, no? All subjects and all courses were designed to become successful. Mathematics, business math, this was designed to become successful so we can learn if we are earning using the business mathematics. Okay, statistics is created as our subject to become successful. English is created to improve our communication system in order to become successful, in order to be to become competitive. Okay. Preliminary to, wala pa tayo sa deeper sense ng strategic management. So, you know now the reason bakit hindi ko tinatanggap na tama yung iba. Okay. Pangalawa, guys, I am checking your answers on the comment box. Maraming parehong-pareho. 100% pareho. Word per word, pareho. Anyway, I will grade you based on your insight. I will consider the first one. Okay lang kung isang reference ang pinagkunan, pero hindi pwedeng pareho ng insight. Parehong-pareho, pati per word, pati period. Okay, 3F, 3G, 3H. Watch out, guys, ha? Okay. No plagiarism, no cheating. Okay. So, I have told you that kung napanood nyo yung first lecture, okay, you know it already. I assume you know it already. If you have watched, but if you have not watched, it's your problem. Okay? Anyway, all insights placed posted on the comment box is graded. Okay? Tatrabahuhin ko yan and that will be the basis of your grade. Huwag mangopya kasi iniisa-isa ko yan. Hindi porke naglagay kayo, okay na, no. Tinitignan ko yung mga pangalan isa-isa kung sino yung pareho. Tatlo ang magkapareho sa isang section. Yung isang section, lima ang magkapareho. Parehong-pareho, pati period, pati comma, pati words, okay? So, what does that mean? Did you copy-paste or you pasted copy? Okay? So, chine-check ko yan isa-isa. I want a quality lecture and I want quality and honest students. I cannot forgive you for cheating. No plagiarism, okay. And then I'm asking for your citation sa inyo kinuha. Never, never use Wikipedia and blogs, social media, author books tayo, okay. All of you is drama students. I require you to download free ebook. Maraming free ebook sa internet, sa Google. Makakapag-download kayo ng libro sa strategic management. Usually ang mga author, Fred David, Michael Porter, Tom Peters, marami kayong each of you should have a copy of this book because I will check it. Hindi kayo makakapasa sa final term kasi checkin ko yung ebook na ni-research nyo, di-download nyo. Ipapasa nyo sa akin yung libro at the same time, you will summarize that. That will be your final. So at least, you have to prepare. All students in Istrama, section 3F, 3G, 3H. Individually, kung kayo, 120 students, you have to download specific book. You have to submit it to me earlier kasi pag nag-submit kayo at may nangopya, iku-consider ko yung unang nag-submit, that is the original. Okay? And then, hindi kayo makakapasa kung wala kayong book sa strategic management. Marami kayong madadownload sa Google. Once na na-download nyo, copy nyo na yan, pwede nyo i-review yan offline. Kahit wala kayong data, marireview nyo yan offline, di ba? You can read it offline, okay? I am giving you the best way how to do it, okay? So, you know now why I could not accept your answer? Ngayon, kung makapag-download kayo ng author book about strategic management, sabihin nyo yung author, yung title ng libro at anong page, baka tanggapin ko kasi maganda yung mga factor na dinidiscuss natin. Huwag manyamba, okay. Konting excerpt ng effort, konting excerpt kasi medyo hirap, lahat tayo hirap. Hirap ang estudyante, mas hirap ang professor kasi professor, isa lang, estudyante niya, nasa 200, 250, 300. So, I am dealing with 300 students, 300 mindset. So, dito sa prelim, once na nakita ko kayo na nag-copy-paste ng ngopya, kanya kinukuha ko yung citation. Yung iba, walang citation. Okay. Dapat yung citation, basahin nyo, unawain nyo, and then provide your insight. Kung nag-provide ng insight, huwag nung ipasa sa iba kasi sa isang section, tatlo or lima yung pare-pareho, as is, pareho, per word, per, pati comma, pati period, pareho. Avoid that. Okay, I'm reading it one by one. Dito pa lang sa prelim, pag nahuli ko kayo, at least may idea na ako kung sino yung okay at kung sino yung hindi nagko-comply. Okay, I'm just giving you an example. doon sa question at paano ito sasagutin. Diba? Okay. Ngayon, nagtanong ako, give me one example of strategies. Ang ginawa ng iba, kung ano-ano pinagsasubmit, pricing strategy, kasi strategy. Samantalang kung may libro kayo or binasa nyo yung lecture, lahat ng sagot nandoon. Ano yung tamang sagot? Upward integration, backward integration, forward integration, market development, product development, siguro mahigit 10 ang nandoon. Okay? Merging, acquisition, liquidation, paliliwanag nyo lang, nandun na yung meaning, nandun na yung factors, paliliwanag nyo na lang ng sarili nyong word. The best insight that you can give me, the better grade that I can give you. Okay, now, you know now why I did not accept your answer. Okay? So, I want a specific answer. Never answer to become competitive, to become successful. Okay? Hindi porke may word na strategy, isa na siya sa part ng isa. It is a small part of strategic management because it is a short-term strategy. While strategic management is a long-term strategy, that from the start of the business, first you have to create your vision statement and then your mission. And how would you compete with your current competitors, di ba? Parang nag-i-exist, let's say, sample, Mercury Drug, di ba? Mercury Drug, drug store. Ngayon, balak mong magtayo, gumawa ka ng feasibility study, generic pharma. How would you compete with Mercury Drug that has been in existence for so many years? Original yan. Ang daming branches, ang daming varieties ng mga items na tinitinda, pati grocery items. How would you compete? Ano ang strategy? Ang strategy niya, product development, generic. That is only an example, ha? That is only a generic example, okay? If you go deeper, maraming process, okay? So guys, your answer should be correct and specific. Plus, provide the source, okay? Again, I repeat, all of you should download an authored books. Tatanggapin ko kahit sinong author, tatanggapin ko kahit kailang edition, kahit edition yan 2010, 2011, 2020 na ngayon, no? 2012, tatanggapin ko pa rin yan. Basta libro. Noon pa, hindi ba, sinabihan ko na kayo, yung mga previous students, huwag gamitin ang Wikipedia because it is not credible. Lahat ng school, hindi pinagagamit ang Wikipedia as a resource because baka maligaw kayo kasi na-e-edit ang Wikipedia, blogs yan yung mga point of view ng isang tao na hindi dumaan sa battery of editors. Walang nag-edit, basta nilagay lang, okay? Provided they have to show citation that we can check, okay? So everything is clear, walang sasagot ng to become competitive and to become successful. It should be specific based on our subject. Our subject is strategic management. Pag sinabi mong to become successful, lahat ng subject nyo, sasabihin nyo yan, iniisip nyo, very good kayo. No. To become successful, it should be explained and give the process. How and why. Okay? So, lahat ng subject, pwede mong isagot yung to become successful and to become competitive. But I want a specific and correct answer. Thank you guys for this. I think this is a short discussion for the YouTube platform. Thank you.